Hello all, in this tutorial we are going to continue about learning of verification keywords. In the earlier tutorial about verification keywords, we have learned about few of the verification keywords. Rest verification keywords we are going to learn in this tutorial. In the earlier tutorial we have learned about the verification keywords in Catalan Studio. Few of the verification keywords that we learned about are verify alert not present, verify alert present, verify all links on current page accessible, and the checkpoint verification. In this tutorial, we will learn about further verification keywords.
Next is verify element attribute value. We can check the attribute value of an element. This also does not have any negative keyword, and in this we have to provide the parameters, that is test object, attribute name, attribute value and timeout. Let's check this. We will check for the attribute value of this test object, that is make appointment link. So I will give this as a test object over here, and our next parameter is attribute name and another parameter is attribute value. So we will check the object repository, the make appointment link, and what are the attributes over here. These are the attributes. If I will take this attribute ID and this button name BTN make appointment, I will give the attribute name as ID and the actual attribute value. Now it is showing underlined, it means we have to provide it in quotes, and we will provide the timeout as 5 seconds. I will save this, we will execute this. It will verify whether the attribute value matches. If it matches, then it will click on the object, else it will not click on the object. It will not perform the further action or further steps. The test case will fail if the attribute value is not correct for that attribute name, that is ID. And it has found the object and the attribute value of that object is same. That's why it has performed the further action, the test is passed. Let's check the next verify keyword, that is the verify element checked. It will check whether the element is checked. This we can use where the checkboxes are used or where the option buttons, radio buttons are used. It will check whether that element is checked. If it is checked, it will go ahead. If it is checked, it will return true value and will be passed. Next is verify element clickable. It checks whether the element is clickable or no. If it is clickable, it will give the true value and will go ahead with the further testing or execution of the further test steps. And if it is failed or provided false value, then the execution will fail. Verify element has attribute. Now we have checked here in the verify element attribute value, we checked the attribute and its value. Here verify element has attribute. It will check whether it has the attribute. For example, if I take this keyword and it is asking for test object and string attribute name. So I will take this and paste it over here, and now I will check what are the attributes are available with this object. There is ID, tag, href, class, text, XPath. I will give some other than this, that is for example I give the type as the attribute, and we will check whether the type attribute is available for this test object. So it will verify whether the type attribute is available. If it is available, it will go ahead with the further testing, and if it is not available, it will fail the test step or test case. Our test case is passed. It has checked whether the attribute is available, and since the attribute is available, it is mentioning here that make appointment has attribute type. So it has attribute type, and that's why it has gone ahead and clicked on the make appointment button. But it has also given us the warning that the timeout 0 is invalid. We have not changed the timeout value over here while executing this keyword. Now let's check for the another next keyword. Verify whether the element is available in the viewport. Viewport is nothing but the given web page or the active page. It returns the true if element is present and visible in the viewport. Otherwise false. It checks whether in this given view area the element is present or not. Next is verify element not checked. This is the negative keyword for verify element checked keyword, where we check that the or verify that the checkbox or radio button or we say option button is clicked or checked or no. The next one is not clickable. This is the negative keyword for the verify element clickable. This one is element not has the attribute, which is the negative keyword for verify element has attribute. Verify element not in viewport. It is the negative keyword for verify element in viewport. Verify element not present, verify element not visible. These are negative keywords. There is difference between verify element present and verify element visible. Verify element present will check whether the element is present in that web page. Even if it is not visible, it is hidden. If it is present in that web page, it will give us the true value. But in case of verify element visible, it will check whether it is visible on the web page. If it is present and not visible, then it will provide us the false value. But this is the verify element not visible keyword. That means it is negative keyword. It will give us the true value if the verify element is not present. This is also negative keyword. So it will provide us the true value if the element is not present. These are the positive keywords of verify element present and visible. And this is the verify element text keyword. It checks for the text of that given element, the test object and the string expected text. For example, in case of make appointment button, we will provide the test object as this make appointment button, and string expected text of that button will be make appointment. So we will provide the make appointment as the string to verify. Then it checks for verify element visible. This is the positive keyword, not visible. Verify element visible in viewport. This is the positive keyword of verify element not visible in the viewport. In this viewport, it is visible or not. Verify equal. It checks whether the object actual object and object expected object. So we have to provide two objects over here, and it will check whether this object are equal, the actual and expected are equal. Verify greater than. This keyword checks the actual and expected number, and it returns the true if the actual number is greater than the expected number, otherwise false. Then there is verify greater than or equal. It checks the actual number is greater than or equal to the expected number. where these verification can be used. These verification can be used when you get the output. What is the actual output and what is the expected output? You can check it by using these verification keywords. You can check the actual and expected result after the test case, and you can verify whether the test case actually passed or not. The next keyword is verify image present. It checks for the image present on the page or no. The given image, the test object of the image. This is verify less than, the similar as verify greater than, less than or equal, similar as greater than or equal. Verify link accessible. This keyword checks the given URL, whether the given URL is available on the page or not. It is accessible or no. The earlier keyword that we have seen, verify all links on the particular page is available or not, accessible or not. This keyword is to check a particular URL, particular link is available on the given page or no. Then the next keyword is verify match. This keyword matches the actual text with the expected text. The way we check for the actual number and expected number, we check for the text or the string whether it matches, and we can verify and say that this test case is passed or failed. Verify not equal. It checks for the objects whether they are equal or not. Verify not match. This is again the negative keyword for verify match for particular actual and expected string. Verify option not present by label. This checks for the label of the test object. It checks whether the given label is available for that test object or no. Verify option not present by value. It checks that test object has the given value, has the given string or no. Then it checks for the index of the object. This indexing or labels we can use in case of drop down verification. Then there are some more keywords that are verify option present by label, verify option present by value, present by index. These keywords can be used again for the drop downs to be checked. Then there are keywords verify text not present. This is the negative keyword for verify text present. It checks whether the given text is present or no on the page. These are few keywords which we can use for our testing, and we can certify whether the given test case is passed or failed. We can check the actual result with the expected result, or we even can use these verification keywords to check a particular value is available in the object with its index value or its attribute. This was about verification keywords in Catalan Studio. If you are new to this channel and would like to learn Catalan Studio from beginning to advanced, please click subscribe and bell icon below this video. Please do not forget to like and share. Thank you.